Hi, Tony again. If you watched the previous video on establishing monitoring plots, you should have an understanding of how to carry out a systematic forest assessment. You can now use these monitoring plots to measure tree growth, stocking rates, potential forest value, or even assess forest health.
In this video, we'll demonstrate how to take two basic field measurements, diameter at breast height, or DBH, and tree height. In the next video, we'll show how to use this forest measurement data to calculate stocking rate, basal area, timber volume, forest growth, above and below ground biomass, and the carbon contained in your forest. Measuring DBH regularly provides an indication of how much a tree is growing. If measurements are repeated annually, it will tell you how tree growth changes from year to year and will indicate when forest growth has stalled, which tells you that it may be time to consider harvesting or thinning your forest.
DBH also has a relationship to the timber volume, biomass, and carbon content of a tree. Using various mathematical equations, DBH can provide a lot of information useful to the farm forester. So let's take a look at how to measure it.
The main piece of equipment you will need is a diameter tape, which can be purchased from forestry supply stores. On one side, it will have a standard scale in centimetres, and on the other side, the scale will give the diameter of the tree when wrapped around the tree stem. Diameter tapes work because of the relationship between the circumference and diameter of a circle, such as the cross-sectional shape of a tree stem. The circumference is equal to the diameter times pi, which is roughly 3.14. The diameter tape scale is based on pi, so that when you measure around the circumference of a tree stem, you can directly read off its diameter. This makes measuring diameters quick and easy, as there is no need for any calculations in the field. You'll also need some way of recording the DBH data. This can be paper and pencil, pre-prepared printed tables, or a tablet or smartphone. You should always record the location of the forest, date, names of the measuring team, plot number and coordinates, species, DBH and height. Then, depending on the purpose of the forest measurement, you might also include parameters such as merchantable height, potential product, health condition or management recommendations. The DBH of a tree stem is measured at 1.3 metres above ground level on the high side of the tree. This is known as breast height. To ensure you are measuring the diameter at the correct height, you can use a stick marked at 1.3 metres or measure that height on your body and take the diameter reading at that point for each tree. Then simply wrap the diameter tape firmly around the tree and read the diameter where the tape overlaps the zero mark to the nearest 0.1 centimetre. There are a few points to remember. On a slope, stand on the high side of the tree. When measuring eucalypts or hoop pine, loose or flaky bark may be removed to obtain a true measurement, but for exotic pines, bark should not be removed. Make sure you're reading the correct side of the tape and ensure the tape is held at right angles to the stem and is not crooked or twisted.
The procedure for standard straight trees is relatively simple, but there are often cases where it's not obvious how to measure DBH. Let's take a look at those.
If the stem is too small to wrap the diameter tape around, the reverse side of the tape may be used to measure the diameter.
In most forest inventories, trees with a DBH less than 10 centimetres are not included in the measurements, as they add little to the total volume of the forest.
For leaning trees on level ground, measure 1.3 metres from the ground on the underside of the tree and wrap the diameter tape perpendicular to the stem. For a leaning tree on sloping ground, imagine rotating the earth so that the tree is vertical, and then locate the measure point as for a tree on a slope. If a tree is distorted at 1.3 metres by branching or swelling, measure the diameter at an equal distance above and below 1.3 metres and use the average of these two measurements. If the tree splits into two or more stems below 1.3 metres, each stem is measured as if it were a separate tree. If you come across a tree with buttressing or fluting at 1.3 metres, measure above the flared part of the stem and make a note of the measure height for the next time you carry out an inventory.
Tree height is defined as the distance from the ground level on the high side of the tree to the uppermost green point. Height is often used to calculate timber volume or biomass, so it is very important to be able to measure it correctly.
In scientific research, we often use a device called a vertex to measure tree height. The Vertex uses an ultrasonic beam to estimate the height of a tree. It is quick and easy to use and requires no calculations as heights are displayed on the screen. These devices make measuring height easy, but are quite expensive. If you are able to access one, it will make your measurements much quicker and easier. In the farm forestry situation, tree height can be measured fairly accurately using some basic inexpensive equipment. A clinometer or clinometer app on a smartphone, a 50 meter measuring tape, data recording sheets or a tablet or smartphone, and a scientific calculator. A clinometer or smartphone app will measure slopes in either percent or degrees. These measurements can be used to calculate tree height using trigonometry when the horizontal distance from the tree is known.
When measuring tree height, there are a couple of rules to bear in mind. Total heights are measured to the nearest tenth of a metre. Each stem of a multi-stem tree should be measured. Take care to read the correct scale, either percent or degrees. Ensure you are sighting the top of the tree. You may need to walk further away from the tree to get a better view, or wait until the tree stops moving if it is windy. When heighting leaning trees greater than 20 degrees, there is a different procedure than for non-leaning trees. We'll explain both methods in this video.
With an assistant holding the end of a tape level to the centre of the tree, walk to a position where you can see the top and bottom of the tree and hold the tape taut at the same height. The distance should be roughly as far from the tree as the tree is tall, so for mature forests, this could be 30 metres or more. Record this distance. Next, determine whether the slope of the ground is greater than 10 degrees, either positive or negative. If you suspect it is, aim a clinometer or smartphone at a point equal to your eye height. Your assistant can indicate this point. If the slope is less than 10 degrees, just use the distance you've measured with the tape as the horizontal distance. However, if the slope is greater than 10 degrees, the horizontal distance must be calculated using the slope distance and the slope angle. Use this formula or a slope correction table to find the horizontal distance that corresponds to the slope distance you've measured. For example, if the distance from the tree was 30 metres on a 16 degree slope, the horizontal distance would be 28.8 metres. Record the horizontal distance, either corrected for slope or read straight from the tape on flat ground. Next, measure the slope to the bottom and top of the tree. Looking through the clinometer, take a reading in line with the base of the tree on the upside slope using the percent scale. Record this number, then take a reading in percent to the top of the tree. To calculate the tree height, use this equation. If the top angle is positive and the base angle is negative, add the two numbers. If the base and top angles are the same sign, subtract one from the other. Multiply by the horizontal distance to get the tree height. Always check whether the calculated height seems reasonable. For leaning trees, heights will be underestimated if the normal clinometer method is used. Trees with a lean greater than 20 degrees and over 5 metres tall should be measured using the following method instead. Stand perpendicular to the direction of lean so that the lean can clearly be seen. With an assistant standing directly under the tip of the tree, which may not be the highest point, measure the horizontal distance from your assistant to the base of the tree if the ground is flat. We'll call this the tip offset distance. If the ground slopes by more than 10 degrees, calculate the tip offset distance using this formula. You will need to know the slope distance from your assistant to the middle of the tree stem and also the slope angle in degrees. Then, using the percentage scale on your clinometer, record the readings to the tip of the tree and to a point level to the base of the tree. Again, make sure the top measurement is to the tip of the tree rather than the highest leaves. Measure the horizontal distance from your position to your assistant's position and calculate the vertical height using the tree height formula from before. Finally, calculate the height of the leaning tree using this formula based on the Pythagoras theorem. For example, if the vertical height is 21 metres and the tip offset distance is 23 metres, the tree height would be 31.1 metres.
Now that you know how to measure DBH and tree height, you can record this data for all the trees in the monitoring plots in your forest. The information you collect can be used to observe how growth changes over time and to calculate additional measures that will assist in forest management planning.